If you hold in a fart, where does it go? Sneezing your eyeballs out, holding in a fart until it backfires, and why your spicy food strategy might be completely wrong. What? Hey everyone, I'm Dr. Jordan Wagner here. Today, we're breaking down 5 of the most searched medical questions on the internet. The ones you've probably thought were dumb, but let's be real, you've definitely wondered about them. All right, let's dive right in. Number 5 top searched health question, can you sneeze with your eyes open? The short answer, nope. That's because your body automatically makes you close your eyes when you sneeze. It's a protective reflex, just like when your doctor taps your knee and your leg kicks up without permission. So here's what's happening. Sneezing is a forceful expulsion of air to clear out irritants from your nose. This process activates the trigeminal nerve, which controls facial reflexes, including blinking. The eye-closing response is likely an evolutionary adaptation to prevent debris from entering your eyes or to reduce pressure in the skull. And while we're on this topic, a closely related myth that we should also clear up, sneezing with your eyes open will not in fact make your eyeballs pop out. This is a myth, my friends. That's because the extraocular muscles and optic nerve are way too strong for that. Sorry, there's no eject button for your peepers. Now, some people can in fact train themselves to sneeze with their eyes open, but it's super rare. And do I recommend it? No. My doctor's stance on this is you should just let your body do what it's supposed to do, like sneeze with your eyes closed very briefly. I'm curious, when you sneeze, how many times do you usually sneeze? 2, 3, 10 times? Let me know in the comments. Number 4 search question, can you actually sweat out toxins? Not really. You see, your liver and kidneys are your real detox machines. Sweating is just your body's way of regulating your body temperature. So, what's actually happening in your body when you sweat? Your body has 2 main types of sweat glands. Number 1, the eccrine glands. These are all over your body and help cool you down. Number 2, sweat glands, the apocrine glands. These bad boys are found in areas like armpits and groin. They release a milky, fatty sweat containing lipids, proteins, and steroid components, as well as metabolic byproducts like ammonia and urea. While this sweat is odorless at first, bacteria on the skin break down its fatty and protein-rich components, producing the body odor we all know and try to avoid. While sweat contains tiny amounts of metabolic waste like urea, ammonia, and trace heavy metals, the amounts are too small to make a meaningful impact on detoxing. Your liver breaks down toxins, and your kidneys filter them out through urine, which is the body's primary way of removing waste. Actually, less than 1% of toxins are excreted through sweat. And yes, you might be thinking, but what about exercise and saunas and that type of sweating? Well, those can definitely make you feel better, but it's not because you're sweating out toxins. It's more about improving circulation and the release of endorphins, heat shock proteins, etc. So while sweating helps regulate body temperature and may improve circulation, it's not an effective detox method. If you want to support detoxification, stay hydrated, eat nutrient-rich foods, and let your organs like your kidneys and liver do their job. So we've established that sweating doesn't detox your body, your liver does. So the important aspect of all of this is to support your liver. That's where Poor Decisions by Life Happens comes into play. It's a liver support and hydration supplement. It's got milk thistle, schizandra, and potassium to help support your liver, especially after a night out. If you hold in a fart, where does it go? All right, first things first, what is a fart, right? Farts are your body's way of releasing gas that builds up due to swallowed air, the digestive process, and other factors. It's very normal to fart. In fact, you should do it. Just maybe not in a packed elevator. But what happens if you hold in a fart? Does it just disappear? No. Here's the science behind it. Gas builds up in your intestines from digestion and swallowed air, as I mentioned earlier. Normally, your body releases it through burping in the upper GI tract or farting in the lower GI tract. If you hold it in, the pressure forces some of the gas back into your bloodstream, where it travels to your lungs and is exhaled through your breath. So yeah, if you hold it in long enough, you might literally be breathing out your fart. Now, holding in gas occasionally isn't dangerous per se, but it can cause bloating and stomach pain, increased pressure in the intestines, and sorry to report, worse smelling gas later. So the doctor in me says, when in doubt, find a discreet moment and fart it out.
God, sorry, I farted.
Number two, can drinking milk actually help with spicy food, or is that a myth? Raise your hand or let me know in the comments if you like spicy food. But yes, milk actually works, and here's the reason why. Spicy foods contain a compound called capsaicin, which binds to TRPV1 receptors in your mouth. These are the same pain receptors that react to heat. Your brain literally thinks your mouth is on fire when you eat spicy food. So why doesn't water help that much? Well, that's because capsaicin is hydrophobic, meaning it doesn't dissolve in water. So when you drink water, it just spreads the burn around, making things worse. And why does milk work? Well, milk contains a protein called casein, which binds to capsaicin and helps wash it away, basically acting like a neutralizer. Think casein as the bouncer at a nightclub grabbing the spicy troublemaker and escorting it out. And you might be thinking about dairy alternatives like almond milk or oat milk. Not the same. You need something with actual casein in it, and it's found in foods like regular milk, yogurt, and cheese. And if you don't have milk, reach for things like bread or rice, which can help absorb the burn, or sugar or honey, which can slightly reduce the sensation. Or you can even go for acidic foods like lemon or vinegar, which can help break down the capsaicin a bit. Remember, next time you accidentally go too hard on the hot wings or the spicy ramen, grab for milk, not water, and definitely not soda. I repeat, definitely not soda, which makes it worse. Number one highly searched question, can you actually wake up during surgery? This one is kind of scary, but yes, it can happen, just not how you might think. It's called anesthesia awareness. It's pretty rare, happening in about 1 in 1,000 surgeries. But first, here's what you need to know about anesthesia and surgery. Why do we use it? Well, anesthesia has three main components. First, you have the unconsciousness part, so you don't wake up during surgery. Then you have the portion for pain relief, AKA, so you don't feel anything during the whole process. And thirdly, the paralysis portion, more for surgeons and hospital staff, so you don't move around during the surgery. In rare cases, patients may regain awareness but can't move or speak because they're still paralyzed in those capacities. Most of the time when this happens, people don't feel pain from the procedure, but they might be semi-aware of their surroundings and know what's happening. So how do doctors prevent it? Anesthesiologists are constantly monitoring your vitals to ensure proper sedation. If you're at higher risk, maybe from a history of substance use or previous awareness, or maybe you're a redhead, which yes, for some reason can affect it, your anesthesia plan can be adjusted. So while anesthesia awareness can happen, for 99.9% of people, you're completely out cold the whole time. No waking up mid-surgery like a weird horror movie. But I'm curious, have you ever woken up during surgery or heard it happen to somebody you know? Let me know in the comments below. There you have it, five of the most highly searched dumb medical questions answered. But remember, no medical question is actually dumb. If you're wondering about it, chances are so is someone else. If you have another medical question, please drop it in the comments below. I might just answer it in the next video. And hey, if you're looking for supplements to support your health, check out Life Happns. Whether it's better sleep you're looking for, more focus and energy, liver support and hydration, or just staying calm, we've got you covered with our supplements. Check out lifehappens.com or click on the link below, or you can find us on Amazon. If you found this video helpful, binge watch this playlist right here and make sure you subscribe. And don't forget to subscribe, turn on your bell notifications, and hit that like button for me. Thank you so much for watching, and stay healthy, my friends.